Hello everyone, this is Ashish Jain. In this video, we will do another illustration payroll. I hope you have already watched and understood all the concepts and how to apply all the basic formulas on payroll. So, on the basis of previous video, we will do a similar illustration on payroll. So, now start with the illustration. Now the fourth illustration is, from the following particulars, compute the salary of Mrs. Y for the financial year 2018 to 19. That is from March 18 to Feb 2019. Basic salary would be in the pay band of 37,400 to 67,000, and the grade pay will be 9,000 per month. The DA in percentage is a percentage of basic plus grade pay is declared after every 6 months in the month of April and October to be effective from July and January respectively. The arrears of DA for the months of January to March and July to September is paid along with the salary from the month of April and October respectively. The DA rates with effect from January 2018 are given below. This whole point we have covered in the last video. This is this very similar point. Okay, now let's read another point. Month of increment in July each year. That means in this question it is given particularly that the month of increment would be from July. The amount of increment is 3% of basic plus grade pay rounded off to the next multiple of 10, provided the increment amount less previous multiple of rupees 10 is not less than rupees 1. See, till the last videos we have covered the round function, and in the all previous illustration we have done round function up to zero decimal place. So in this point they are saying that we need to apply the round function, that should be in the next multiple of rupees 10. Okay, so we will understand this point in the Excel sheet. Now the next point is for HRA. HRA is to be paid at 30% of basic pay plus grade pay to those whom HRA is payable is yes. Then traveling allowance is to be paid at rupees 3200 per month, and DA on TA as given in point number 3. Okay, that which means that there is a DA which is dependent on DA. Okay, that means we again we need to do this point similar to DA. Okay, so again we will understand this point in the Excel sheet. Then the gross salary is the summation of salary and all the allowances. Then there are two deductions, gross provident fund and income tax, and the net salary would be gross salary minus deductions. Okay, so let's understand this illustration very well in the Excel sheet. Now I have already made a draft for this particular illustration, and first let's make, there is some correction. Okay, now the basic pay for the month of March 2018. Now in this question the basic pay band is given to you, that is start from 37,400 to last 67,000, but there is amount of increment is not given to you, as we did in the previous question that the fixed amount of increment is given to you. So we will do with the help of data validation. But in this question the fixed amount of increment is not given to you, so in this question we need to assume the basic salary. Okay, so for this let's assume that the basic salary would be 37,400. Okay, then the month of increment is July. Again it's given and is HRA payable. This we will do with the help of data validation. So go to data, select data validation, allow list, and then create your list, yes, comma, no, then okay, and then select yes. Okay, so we will do all these workings here. Okay, now on the right side, I have already made this table as we did in the last session, that the effective month of DA would be from January 2018 and the effective rate would be 3500. And I'll make another column for declared month, like on which month DA rate is declared. That means from January, that means as per the question, the declaration month would be April 2017, then next would be October 2017, then April 2018, then October 2018, then last April 2019. Okay, so let's start with the first column, that is basic. Now for the basic, for the month of April 2018 would be this. Okay, so let's fix this value. You can fix this value by pressing F4. Okay, now we have already known that the month of increment from July, so which means from March to June the basic salary would be remain same. Okay, now from July onwards there would be increment. How much increment? The month of increment in July each year, amount of increment is 3% of basic plus grade pay, rounded off to the next multiple of rupees 10. Now first let's understand this point very well. Like as we did in the last video, like suppose 787.8. Now if we round this value up to zero decimal place, we will get this. Okay, but suppose if we have this value okay, and if we apply again this round function up to zero decimal place, then we will get this. But in this question we need to round up, we need to apply round up function, that means we need to round up to tens decimal place. Okay, so how do we do? Equal to round up, select this value, comma, and type minus 1. Now you can see very well that the value come to rupees that the value come to 1050 from 1045.61. okay, that means this value is round up to 10th decimal place. Okay, that means the value is round up, the value is shifted towards left from the decimal place. Okay, so we will apply this roundup function here. Now equal to roundup, the amount of increment is 3% of basic plus grade pay. Oh sorry, before this we need to do here is for grade pay first. The amount of grade pay is fixed. Okay, as per the question, the amount of grade pay is 9000 per month, that is fixed. Okay, now let's apply this formula here. Round up, double bracket. Now this will be 3% of 3% of sorry. Three percent of basic plus grade pay. Okay, then we need to add this whole value to the basic. Okay, then we need to round up to 10th decimal place minus 1. Now close the bracket and then press enter. Okay. So this will be the value. Now drag it to down. Sorry, actually this value is, sorry, actually this value, this whole value will be fixed. Sorry, dollar sign. Dollar, because the increment from July onwards, so we need to fix up the whole value here. Okay, so the basic salary from March to June would be 37,400 and from July onwards would be 38,800, and the grade pay will be fixed. Okay, now come to the next column, that is for DA. So for the calculation of DA, we will do the same procedure that we as we did in the last video. So for the DA, as we did in the last example, that the month of increment, sorry, that the effective month of DA would be for the month of March 18, the DA rate would be 45%, because the last declaration is on October 2017. Okay, so the effective rate would be 45% for the month of March 18. Okay, so equal to round basic plus GP, that is C7, multiplied by DA rate, which is 45%, and then round up to 0 decimal place. Okay, then for the month of April, that is in this month the DA rate would be declared. Okay, that is April 2018, and the new rate will be 51%. So equal to round double bracket basic plus GP, that is C8, multiplied by 51%, and round up to 0 decimal place. Okay, now this value will be remain same for the next 6 months. Okay, so for this, that means till September, this value will remain same. So for this, we need to fix up this Q4, that is rate. Okay, and then drop down to till September. Okay. Now from October onwards, the new D rate will be 58%. So equal to round double bracket basic plus GP, that is C14, multiplied by new D rate, which is 58%, and then round up to 0 decimal place. Okay, so for this we need to again fix up the new rate. it is Q5. Okay, and let's bold this value also. Okay, now for the DA arrear, the DA arrear would be paid in the month of April and October. Month and April and October. Okay, so this also we will do as we did in the last video. So the DA arrear for the month of April, that means we are paying DA for the 3 months, like from January to March. Like you can read this, that the DA arrear for the month of January to March and July to September is paid along with the salary for the month of April and October. Okay, so the DA rate would be equal to round double bracket. Now the DA rate would be equal to round basic plus GP multiplied by differential rate. What is differential rate? The current DA rate, that is 51%. Wait, first bracket open here. Yes, and minus the previous DA rate, minus, that is 45%. Okay, now this area they are paying for the 3 months, so multiplied by 3. Okay, now we need to close round function. So we are rounding up to zero decimal place. And then enter. Okay, and this same formula we will apply here: round double bracket basic plus DA and multiply by differential rate. Now for the month of October, the new DA rate will be 58%, and the previous DA rate was 51%. And they are paying arrear for the 3 months and round up to zero decimal place. Okay, so this is all about DA arrear. Now come to next column, that is for HRA. Now HRA is to be paid at 30% of basic plus GP to whom HRA payable is yes. So equal to round. If this cell is equal to yes, then HRA would be 30% of basic plus GP. Basic plus GP, otherwise it will be zero. Otherwise it will be zero. Now close the if function, and now last before closing round function we need to put zero value and then close this one. Okay, so this will be the HRA. Now here we need to fix up the B3, this cell. Okay, now drop down to last. So this will be the HRA. Now come to traveling allowance. TA is to be paid at 3200 per month, and the DA on TA is given in point number 3. First, the TA amount will be 3200. This amount would remain same for whole year. Now DA on TA. Okay, that means the company is paying TA including DA. Okay, so we need to add this value. How do we add? Equal to round deteriorate is this and multiplied by the D rate. Now D, for this month the D rate was 45% and round up to zero decimal place. Press enter. Okay, now for this we need to fix up this Q3. Okay, and then drop down to last. Okay, now TA arrears, that means again they are paying arrear for DA, for TA in the month of April and October. Okay, so equal to round TA multiplied by their differential rate, that is 51% minus 45% for the 3 months. That is why they are saying that we need to pay arrears as per the point number 3. Okay, and round up to zero decimal place. Now close this, we will get this value. Now the same formula we will apply for the month of October also. Round TA multiply by differential rate, that is 58% minus 51% for the 3 months, and round up to zero decimal place. Now for the next column is for gross. Now the gross will be summation of all summation basic and all allowances, basic plus all arrears and allowances. Now drop down to last. Now for the provident fund, the point is GPF would be 10% of basic plus GP. So again we need to apply round function. 10% of basic plus GP, down up to zero decimal place. We need to apply multiply sign here. Okay, then drop down to last. Now for income tax. Income tax is 10% of gross salary. So round 10%. 10% of gross, round up to zero decimal place. Now the total deduction would be PF plus IT. And the net salary would be gross minus total deduction. Now for the total we will apply some function here also. And then drop to the right side also. Okay, so this is the whole concept of payroll. Okay, so this illustration was very similar to the previous one. I hope you understand this concept very well. In the next video, we will do another illustration of payroll. Thank you. Please keep like and subscribe my channel.